Please, I beg you, just hold some minutes for me. Just dash me these few minutes. And I want you to listen, help me thank God, and learn from my testimony. Praise the Lord. My testimony goes like this. On Monday this week, or last week, how do I put it? This Monday, I came back a little bit late on Sunday. So on Monday morning, my wife don't want to disturb me. She just prepared herself and went to work. So around 12 p.m., she's been calling my private number. I've not been taking it due to, you know, on Sundays, we have to put our phones in silent. Then after that, I forgot to put it in ringing as well. So when she was calling me, I can't hear the ringing. So when she called the house phone, I was able to pick it up. So she told me that she's very sick, that I have to come and pick her up. Wow, I was a kind of, what kind of sickness? You went to work yourself. How come I'm going to come and pick you up? She said, this is the lady. That she's not going to talk more. She don't have the strength. Man, I have to rush to her office. Getting there, I called her that I'm in front of the office. I saw my wife coming out from her office as if she has been beaten, you know? When you have been beaten and you have internal injury, even though you are walking, you know, your walking will be somehow. So when I saw her, I said, wow, what's all this? So she entered the car. I asked her, do we go to hospital or what? She said, no, let's go to house first. So we went home. Immediately we got home, she just went straight to bed. Even at Ikewanko called me that day. There was something he wanted me to do for him, but I told him, brother, I cannot. There is situation right now. By then, things is just normal. So she's been lying on the bed for the past 30 minutes. So I went there, you know, I became harsh to her. I said, what is wrong with you? How can you tell me that you're sick? I have to come and pick you up. Then I'm picking you up. You just went to bed straight. You can't even tell me what is wrong with you. So when she noticed that I'm a little bit angry, she came out in the sitting room where I am. She said she don't know how it happened. That she was in her office. That there is one woman that her contract is supposed to finish that day. So when she came, she had never offered her anything before. So that morning, she offered to give her an asila mark. So she said no, that she's not hungry. So she opened the soya she had, sipped it a little bit and dropped it. So went and did something and came back to her desk. So as she was sitting at her back, the desk, the woman came there, touched her here, just here at the back of neck like this. So she said immediately she began to feel uncomfortable. She began to dizzy, you know. It seems like she will vomit. Now she went to the bathroom. Getting to the bathroom, she can't even vomit. So on her way out from the bathroom, she fell down. So when she fell down, her office smelled, come and help her up. She said that her boss was a kind of, what is wrong with you? She said she told her boss to give her like 30 minutes that she's going to be fine. So before the 30 minutes, she got herself a little bit before then. That was when she told me. So when she told me this thing, my brother, I became afraid, you know, because my wife is healthy and all that. And the last thing she will do is to call you to come and pick, even though you have appointments, as far as it's working time, it's not for her. She doesn't play with her work. So when she told me that story, I said, no, I have to call Pastor. I called Pastor, Pastor Ken. I called her, please come and explain to Pastor what happened to yourself. So she came and explained to Pastor. Pastor said, okay, that nothing will happen to her. Pastor thought it's a simple thing, you know, it's just a small thing. Pastor prayed a simple prayer and went back. So when Pastor went back, it seems like that force is maybe has been awakened. So when Pastor went back, it's not up to five minutes. She called me, she said it's very hard for her to breathe. That she can't even breathe. I said, what? You can't breathe. She didn't talk to me again. So I now called Guru. I said, brother, I called Guru. His girlfriend picked it up. I said, please, give Guru the phone. She gave Guru the phone. So I told Guru, please, do you have olive oil in your house? Boom said yes. I said, please give Mecca the olive oil to run to my house immediately. Boom said, what kind of olive oil and run to my house? What's happened? I told her that my wife was very, very sick right now. She said, okay, she will come with the girlfriend. They came. When they came in, they saw her lying on the bed and I was by her side. So Dudu instructed us to pull off her clothes and use that olive oil all over her body. Check out to the extent when we was rubbing the olive oil, you can't even touch her. If you are touching her, more especially in her stomach, she will say, oh, it's very bad, don't, she's a kind of crying, you know? So we insist, I put it in her mouth, everywhere. So all of a sudden, she calmed down a little bit. Before you could know it, she started again. To the extent she can't breathe anymore. The thing is too much that I have to tell you to call pastor before pastor can come. I'm telling you, my brother, my wife died and come back alive. She stopped breathing. I was holding her. If her hand goes like this, it will come down and completely. She was a kind of throwing down. Before I could know it, her body has teeth. She can't move, she can't breathe. Everybody in that house started crying. I was crying, Mecca was crying, Duru, everybody was crying because all we thought is that we've lost her. So we cried, everybody, then all of a sudden everybody started praying. We prayed close, if I'm not mistaken, the prayer lasted more than 4 hours. So all of a sudden, Pastor prayed and told her to stand up and rise. So she was able, you know, she has a strong faith. She was able to get up and walk a little bit. Walk, she can't walk. Now she fell down, she come down again. I told them, please help me. They carry her on top of a chair. Then she vomits. After that vomit, she got herself a little bit. So when she got herself a little bit, you know, even that time she was a kind of gone. She was saying that she can't breathe, she can't see anybody. To the extent she was on that unconsciousness, she said, they are kicking me every day, I want to kick back. Brother, do not hear, bear me witness, or Sister Mecca. So we said, okay, don't worry, when you get yourself, you kick them back. So after all said and done, she got herself completely. Then she told me that she wants to see Pastor. I said, okay, Pastor came inside the room. She was telling Pastor how she went into the coffin. She went to a kind of comfortable place, but we couldn't allow her to stay there even for a minute. So my brothers, I want you to help me to thank God. God, who did not allow me to be a witness?